The same conversation after the Portland game, but LeBron, this level of efficiency on offense and kind of carrying you home tonight with a little help from Reaves. So what did you make of his fourth quarter and just the level of play throughout the game?
Can you ask that one more time? Can I get a new stat sheet? Say that one more time. I'm sorry, Mike.
I'll just shorten it. LeBron, good. A lot of efficiency.
He was outstanding. The LeBron we've all come to know and love over these 21 years. We just had to find a way. We weren't shooting the ball particularly well. Had to take it back to the mid-90s. There with AD in that stretch, just feeding them on the post, and we're able to get a lot done, slow them down a little bit. That's a hell of a ball club on that side, man. Ime and his staff, they're doing a great job re-establishing and winning a culture with the Houston Rockets. They're new additions, Dylan, Fred, Jeff Green. Like, you can see the effect that they're having on the game, but more so on those younger guys that they have over there, Jabari and Jalen. They're doing a hell of a job, and nothing but respect for the job they're doing. I know they'll continue to do so, and it's not the Houston of recent years. It's wild all over the place. They're really deliberate in how they try to play. So with us, the thing we talked about at halftime is just, digging in defensively. Again, keeping them off the glass, a bunch of strong, forceful, athletic guys, and then playing downhill, us playing meeting force with force offensively. And from Bron, AD, all these guys, AR, Rui, I thought we did a good job of that screening for one another, playing downhill, not settling, and getting into the paint, and putting pressure on them, which in turn led to us getting some free throws. But on a tough shoot night, it's a good win to get when you don't see the ball go in as often as you think it should based on the shot quality that you get.
There was the game last week with the 22 made threes where it seemed like, the pressure gets less with every shot. Tonight and many other nights this year, it seems like it's been the opposite. What's your strategy with talking to guys, if at all, and when you see that happen, or how do you approach that?
I mean, I think Torian had a rough shooting night tonight. He came off, I told him, I've seen you hit those shots plenty of times, keep shooting them. All of the guys, I mean, we're getting good looks. We just gotta trust our work, continue to trust our work.
You mentioned it was like an 80s throwback, started into the post, the 80 in the third quarter to get things going. There's kind of been like a push-pull with that. Like, obviously, 80's not the point guard, so he can't necessarily dictate where the offense is going to go. With five outs, some he can. But when stuff like that happens, how much is that him planning himself down there, calling for it? How much is the coaching staff recognizing this is something we can go to? How much is it his teammates kind of setting up that action?
Well, I actually drew up the first play coming out of halftime for him to post. I'm constantly thinking of ways to get him some touches, get him going. And it's the same with his teammates. Luckily, we have a little bit of corporate knowledge from last year. It's a play I put in. It's a part of our sideline out of bounds package, but it's called RIP. And basically for him to get a post up, post touch. And, we called it on the fly. The guys out there, some guys we had from last year knew what it was, and we were able to just continuously feed him. And so, and again, he draws a lot of attention. They had the double team, which opened up some slashing lanes and some open looks behind the double team. So it was good, man. I just think, he wants to play the game the right way, but we know how forceful and how big of an impact he can make down when he's down low, when he's attacking in the paint. And we try to feed him as much as possible to exploit that.
Darvin, when LeBron plays the way he plays, when AD plays the way he plays, and Austin plays the way he plays, like typically like that game will come down to a final shot or something like that. Do you just view that? Is it simply just shot making at this point for some of the other players? What's holding you guys back?
I mean, those guys are going to hit those looks. We wholeheartedly trust those guys to take those shots, and I want to continue to take them. Some nights the ball just doesn't go down for whatever reason. But, yeah, I mean, Bron, AD, Austin made some huge, huge plays on both sides of the ball down the stretch. And, you know, you kind of go with the flow, and they're high-level thinkers when it comes to their basketball IQ. They tried to hit double-team Bron as he was isolating Dylan. And he made a quick swing, and Austin made a shot that he's made hundreds of times. And was clutch, and, you know, such as he's been for us since I've been here, down the stretch, making huge, huge plays, whether it's him scoring the ball, him setting up a teammate, or putting the defense in a position where they have to foul him. But it was good. I just think, you know, I'm comfortable with all the shots we got, the looks we got. And again, it's early in the season, with 14 games in now. You know, the pendulum will swing in our favor in terms of shot making, for sure.
That's my coach.
Looking ahead to Tuesday, you guys have the Jazz NCAA tournament. Just, I guess, what's, you guys know what's on the line? Just how do you, I guess, manage those maybe emotions, or just manage the situation knowing, you know, what's on the line at the end of the day?
This is a big block of games, man. Just not just, you know, I understand the ramifications for that game being an NCAA tournament game, but it's, you know, the stretch of game, we came out of a 3-4 nights. We're going into a 3-4 night, so. Like it's something like 8 games in 14 days, maybe. I don't know, but it's felt like a lot. So just the biggest thing right now is the recovery game, and you know, we'll get our maintenance in tomorrow, and you know, be ready for Utah to talk about Utah Tuesday morning. But we're just trying to be the best version of ourselves, the biggest version of ourselves, and keep putting the right foot in front of the other.
Thanks, Coach.
Thank you.
You shot the ball well, just having a lot of attempts tonight, and as a team, the threes weren't going down. Is there any part of your brain before you get the ball late like that that has any of that in your mind? You have to push some of it out, and just kind of take us through that play once you get the ball and release that three?
I just believe in myself. Brown made a good pass and thought I was open. They kept telling me it was really deep. I didn't even really, I don't think I understood how far it was, but just trying to get a good look and make a shot.
Austin, you didn't play your typical amount of playing time in Portland the other night, just to be able to have this type of result, not only the win, but be so key in it down the stretch. What does that do for kind of your mental space within this team?
I mean, we won in Portland, right? Yeah. So, I mean, the win, that's all that matters. That's it. But, you know, I stay focused, stay ready to, you know, hopefully contribute however I can contribute. And tonight, that was late in the game, and it was good to, you know, pull out a win.
Guys, you were both there last year when Dylan Brooks said what he said about LeBron, and you saw the way LeBron responded last year. I don't know that I've ever seen him do, like, a too small on the court. Did you see a different juice in him today? And I guess beyond that, can you just sort of speak to the run that he's been on to start the year?
I mean, I don't know what's the beef between those two guys, but you know, I know they've been doing it for a while, especially last year, the playoff. You know, they had, you know, things going on, but you know, you know, for Bron, you know, it's nothing. You know, it's actually good for him. He need that motivation, so you know, it's actually bring him more, you know, to the game. And as you guys seen, like, it's whatever he's doing, and like, it doesn't do anything to him. You know, he actually scored more. He's, you know, he gets rebound more. He, you know, and we've been winning. So yeah, those are things like, you know, just, you know, Dylan Brooks. He just wanna, you know, be part of it. You know, his legacy, I guess.
You want me to answer? That was a good answer. I don't know. The one special thing about Bron is, I was telling someone this the other day, I've never really seen him in a bad mood. He's always got energy. You know, he's the oldest player in the NBA, but, you know, still acts like he's 20 every day. Just joking around, having fun. But I think he plays the game the same way, regardless of who he's playing. And, you know, like Rui said, you know, anytime Bron has something that pushes him a little, you know, further, you see the results like you get tonight, like last year in the playoffs. You know, he just did more after all that stuff started happening.
Okay.
You pointed after the shot. First off, the shot was far, by the way. But you pointed to the crowd. Was that to Bronny after you made that three? Two?
Go ahead.
Yeah.
You got it.
Oh, that was it.
Yeah, I seen him up, you know, clapping, celebrating. So, you know, those moments, adrenaline kind of takes over and you just have fun with it. But yeah, that was towards him.
Austin, you've hit a few kind of really deep threes this year. You've taken a handful. Is that a point of emphasis at all for you this year to kind of expand your range at all in the court?
No, I just, you know, try to take good shots, you know, hopefully make a lot more, you know, shots going forward, but, you know, just try to play the game the right way, take good shots, and do whatever I can do to, you know, help the team be successful. And, yeah, y'all go talk to Ron.
Hey, to both of you guys, you know, I think before the season there was some hope that, you know, with deeper roster and stuff, that maybe you guys can unburden LeBron a little bit. I was just kind of feel wondering, one, how do you guys feel, I guess, about that responsibility to maybe, right, what you guys can do? What are some of the things you guys can do to maybe, you know, make it so that you guys, right, he doesn't have to play, say, 40 minutes or whatever to, for you guys to win games? And how far do you think you guys are from being that team, you know, right now?
Got it.
I mean, we won't play 40 minutes. But, you know, it's a team, you know. Like, as you guys saw last year, you know, in the playoffs, you know, we made a big run, and you know, most of the guys, the main guys, came back, and you know, we've been building the chemistry. You know, we've been still trying to figure it out, and we had a couple new guys, and you know, we have a different lineups every day, different rotations. So we're still trying to figure it out. But you know, I think we're getting better. You know, I can feel that. You know, our chemistry getting, you know, stronger every day, and yeah, we just gotta keep going.
Yeah, if Bron plays like this, we want him to play 48 minutes. So, no, that's really it. You know,
he's 38, right? I mean,
yeah. I remind him every day he's old. I mean, in basketball years, I just told him that again, and you know, he's fighting Father Tom better than I'd say anybody, you know, that's played the game other than maybe Tom Brady. But you know, like I said. You know, he's playing at a really, really high level.
For both you guys, in-season tournament, at least the group stage part of it, you guys wrap it up on Tuesday. You can advance to the knockout rounds with a win over Utah. Have you guys felt any extra juice in these past three in-season tournament games? And have you guys thought about what it would look like advancing beyond the group stage yet?
I mean, for me, anytime I play, you know, a game, you compete to win. And in that sense, it's no different. But you know, it'd be cool to, you know, say you won the first in-season tournament. You know, we're 3-0 right now. I have a chance to go 4-0 against Utah, and you know, go to Vegas to, you know, compete for that. So I'm definitely looking forward to that.
Yeah, I mean, I still don't know the rules. Like, I don't know. So next game, if we win next game, we're going to Vegas.
If you beat Utah, you have a home game in the quarterfinal to try to get to Vegas for the semi.
So we don't know yet until...
If you beat Utah, you will be the one or the two seed in the West.
Oh, okay.
And then you would be in the quarterfinal.
Okay.
But you have to win the quarterfinal to get to Vegas for the semi.
Okay. Yeah, we of course want to go, you know.
Right?
I didn't know that.
We're 3-0 now, so... But, you know, like he said, you know, every game is, like, for us, it's, like, really important, you know. We have a bigger goals, so you know, we just trying to figure out ourselves, and we trying to win the games every time. So you know, yeah.
Playing time もたくさんもらって、試合の接戦の試合の最後のみプレーするという自分が目指していた今日できたと思うんですけれども、どういったことがこういった出場時間最後までプレーするというところにつながってきたと思いますか。
そうですね、まあ、ディフェンスってところが一番大きいんじゃないかなと思いますけど、ディフェンスのところでそういう動きをしたり、いいところを見せるところで、まあ、僕がオフェンス持ってるってことは誰も知ってるので、コーチたちもチームとしても、まあ、そこのディフェンスのところで動きができたところが、その最後まで残れたっていうあれだったんじゃないかなと。
同じあのディフェンスのことでもう一つなんですけれども、あのシーズンの前にハムヘッドコーチに対して、あの今年はディフェンスをさらに向上させますというふうに言ったというふうに聞いてるんですけれども、どういう気持ちでそれをハムコーチに特に声に出して口に出してそういうふうに言った理由っていうのは何だったんでしょうか。
僕がディフェンスをってことですか。
あ、そうです。ハムコーチに対して八村選手が今年はディフェンスをもっとうまくやりますと。言ったというふうにハムコーチは言ってたんですけれど、
やっぱりディフェンスは、まあ、1対1とかやっぱりそういうところでは僕はできるんですけど、そういうローテーションのところとかでチームのやっぱそういうシステムがあるので、そういうのになれるっていう意味でやっぱりこの、まあ、コーチ のやってるやり方でもっとできるようにっていうことでそういう意味で言いました。
Thank you.